Hi, I'm Kim Sauer at SMT Nuremberg. I'm joined today by Rick Nuttall from Metcal. Rick, it's great to see you here.
Afternoon.
So, again, you're very active here in Germany on the market as well as, of course, here at the show. So, what's your focus this year at SMT Nuremberg?
So, at the show this week, we brought a new product, Scarab. It's a standalone solder scavenger. We don't believe there's another product of its type on the market at the moment, so we're previewing it at the show, due to launch next month, aimed at high density output BGA type components, where there's a big problem with companies cleaning up the land area, so it scavenges not just the solder, it also takes off the glue. So where people are dealing with underfills in a rework situation, we've brought a solution to the market that doesn't exist. So that really is our focus.
Okay, so literally a launch at the show or a pre-launch at the show.
Yeah.
What's been your feedback so far over the last 2 days here?
Feedback has been pretty good. We've had a couple of customers who've specifically travelled up to the show just to see the Scarab. Problems with glue and underfill on small BGA type devices. Very interested, want the product in now to do some extended trials, so it's quite encouraging.
So these are issues that face a number of industries. Are there particular ones that you're focusing on?
Yes, the industry that really will have these problems is anybody who's involved in smartphone type technology assembly, tablet type technology, where you've got packing densities, high pinouts on small footprint BGAs, difficult land areas to clean up in a rework situation. Traditionally cleaned with a soldering iron. The difficulty with soldering iron cleanup is that it's manual, and if it's manual, it's subject to human error, which means damage. And if you've got expensive PCBs, you can't afford that damage.
Yeah. Now, a lot of these type of applications are associated with high volume, which as we all know, is
in Asia.
But we're seeing a lot more business coming over into the more traditional European or even the American highly critical industries, aerospace and automotive, where the two are merging together. Are you finding that actually those type of industries are also now having these issues of high density, highly complex boards and problems such as those and need those solutions?
Well, that actually is exactly what's happened. The concept behind this product was really to target the large volume manufacturers in Asia of smartphones. That was the target audience, and our expectation in the North America and Europe was relatively low in terms of volume for this product. The surprise, I think, for us has been that we've actually had quite a number of companies come to us and say, we have an application in the European market, and it's not the application that we anticipated, which was the high volume smartphone manufacturer type application. It is the lower volume but high value customers that are interested.
Sure. So quite a few opportunities and maybe some new markets opening up for you then.
Yeah, we're hoping so. Automotive for sure.
Yeah.
Military, aerospace, those are going to be the key sectors.
And those are the big ones, obviously, here in Europe and certainly automotive in Germany.
Yeah.
You mentioned it's a pre-launch, and obviously you're going to roll it out, and I'm sure we'll see a big presence of it at Productronica as well. Is this going to be the focus for you for the next coming months and maybe the year?
This will be the focus for us, certainly, between now and Productronica. We've got new products coming again at Productronica. We've gone through a fairly hefty development program at Metcal. We've gone a few years without any significant product launches, but we're going to go into a phase where we've got a few things that we need to now bring to the market. So this will be the focus. There'll be another focus post-Productronica with some newer product. But yeah, for the next 12 months, this will be where we're at.
Excellent. Well, I wish you great success with that, and thank you very much for your time today.
Thank you for yours.
Thank you.